Whether you've been naughty or nice this year, everyone deserves a sweet treat. And a classic sweet treat is bizcocho, which is basically sugary buttered toast. But I want to make it a little Christmassy. So I thought maybe let's make a ginger bizcocho and let's pair that with a watermelon jam. So I've got some watermelon here, really nice and red. This is a seedless watermelon, so it makes our job a lot easier. Now this may look like a lot of fruit, but actually when you cook it down, it's all gonna go, you know, really down and turn into slight mush. So you're gonna be left with about just like a third of this after. So usually you use berries to make jam, but I like the subtle taste of watermelon. It's not so in your face. So when you cook it down, you get to enjoy the flavor of the watermelon without, you know, being so overpowering. And also, it gives you that really, really nice red color that goes over really well for Christmas. So to this, I'm going to add some lemon juice. Now, it depends on how juicy your lemon is. Maybe about one whole lemon. When you add that sour taste to the jam, it gives it an extra taste. So it's not like a one note, like super sweet jam. So it has the sweetness and a little bit of sourness just to bring out, you know, extra flavor. So I'm gonna add about a cup of sugar. That's basically my starting point. The best way really is to taste the fruit. It's pretty sweet. We'll stick to one cup. And I'm using normal table sugar, because if you use brown sugar, it might actually mess with the color of the watermelon, and it's a really nice red color now, so I don't really wanna mess it up. And we're just gonna boil this up, and that is it. I'm not gonna add extra water to it. Watermelon has a lot of water to it, and the sugar and the lemon juice and the heat, they're all going to force that liquid out of the watermelon. Give it a good mix. And you're basically just gonna boil this until it has this syrup texture, and then we blend it. So my watermelon jam is bubbling away, and now let's take care of the bizcocho. We're gonna use white bread, you know, the one you normally have at home. Just line them up. So this time I'm not gonna cut the crusts off, because I think the crusts will actually help make the bizcocho extra crunchy. On a normal sized white bread slice like this, you can cut that into three. They don't have to be really even. I mean, making uneven slices actually helps people remember that this is homemade and not machine made. So just line them up. Close together at first makes our job a lot easier. So to this, we're gonna add some butter, but not just ordinary butter. Let's call this the Christmas butter. So I'm melting some unsalted butter here. And to this, we're gonna add a little bit of Christmas flavors. So when I hear Christmas, I think of cinnamon and ginger. And that's what we're gonna add. So I have some powdered ginger here. So I'm using about a teaspoon for one stick of unsalted butter. For the cinnamon though, I'm gonna use about half a teaspoon, because cinnamon is very, very strong. And we want the flavors to be about the ginger and the watermelon jam. So the cinnamon is just to help things along. This we're gonna bring back to the stove, very, very low heat, and we're just going to let the flavors melt together. So this should be done in about 15 minutes. But to be safe, you might want to check on this after about 10 minutes. If it's already browning on the edges, you may want to take it out. So it's time to check on our jam. So just give this a good mix. And you can see that the liquid has gotten a lot thicker. And the way to check it is to use a spoon. Just get a spoon and dip it into the jam. Just draw a line And if the line holds, then you know the jam is ready. So in the olden days, when they made jam, they actually used a wooden stick and tried to crush the fruits individually, or they'd serve a chunky kind of jam. But I actually like a smooth jam. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put it in the osterizer and blend it. It makes things a lot faster and a lot easier. So just give this a quick buzz. And once you hear this sound, then you know it's pretty smooth already. And that is it. We've got our jam. So I've got a nice Christmas bowl here. I'm going to pour in the jam. So it looks very liquid right now. So you've got to give it a chance to thicken up in the ref. And let's get our bread. Wow, the smell. Intoxicating. Look at that. That golden brown, lightly toasted color. Beautiful. And that aroma, it smells of the ginger and the cinnamon. It smells like Christmas. Okay, let's get our jam. And I want to taste this. So I've kept the jam pretty loose, so it's easy to spread. Mmm. You get that really nice watermelon taste. And it's not overly sweet. And combined with the ginger and the cinnamon and the butter. Wow. This is very, very naughty, but it tastes very, very nice. It's now time to make our Christmas drink. Try as I may, I really don't like eggnog. So I came up with a different kind of Christmas drink. So we're gonna make a spiced fresh mango milkshake. So we've got some nice ripe mangoes here. All we need is the meat. We're in the Philippines. I figured, why not make a drink with our most famous fruit, which is mango. So our mangoes are ready. And I'm gonna put them all in the blender. Since I'm making milkshakes for a dozen people, it's time to bring out the big guns. We're gonna add 4 scoops of ice cream. Then we're gonna add some milk. So about 2 cups. And then to make it extra thick, we're gonna add some ice. Top that off. And it's time to start your engine. Now that is a sexy and powerful engine. So this is your basic milkshake recipe. So if you're serving this to kids, this will be the best milkshake they've ever had. But we're gonna add some adult flavors to it. So first, a little bit of allspice. A little bit of nutmeg. And then we're gonna add some booze. Got some mango rum here. So it only serves to add more mango flavor. And of course, that happiness that booze brings. So you can put as much mango rum as you want. And basically, if you want your party to be really happy, just add more. And there you go. Let's give this a taste. The flavors of the mango rum, and the spices They are all blended together beautifully. Fantabulous. It's frantic, it's busy, but it's still the most wonderful time of the year. Especially when you know you're going to be sharing a specially prepared meal with people who matter the most. Everyone, I'd like to thank you for coming and joining me in this Christmas. So, happy holidays, Merry Christmas, Happy New Year. Cheers!
Cheers! Cheers.
Have a ho-ho-wholesome Christmas.